Victoria's new Labor Premier, Daniel Andrews, will have a difficult term ahead as smaller parties are set to hold the balance of power in the upper house. The Australian Sex Party's Fiona Patten has secured one of those seats and she joins us now. Good morning to you. Fiona, what does the Australian Party, Sex Party, actually stand for?
Well, fundamentally, we're a civil liberties party, so the things that we took to this election were things like voluntary euthanasia, a secular society that keeps a fair separation of church and state, and, of course, drug law reform were amongst some of our campaign policies.
And, Fiona, I feel like your party is kind of the political equivalent of the sign that says, sex, now that we've got your attention, here's all this other sort of things. You have been around a bit. This, I think, is the first seat you've won in any parliament in Australia, is that right?
That's right. We're in our fifth year, so we sort of got running in 2010. And yet this is the first time that we've won a seat around Australia.
Do you think your party, Fiona, offers something that the electorate wants? I ask because I was listening to something this morning on the BBC that suggested that modern politics was letting the people down, that they were delivering policies and rules that existed in, say, the 19th century. They're still old hat, and today's people want a different kind of commitment from their leaders. And the reason there's such distrust of politicians is because they're not delivering what people actually want.
I think that's absolutely true, Aisha. And I think, you know, voluntary euthanasia is a great example, where we've got probably 86%, or the vast majority of Australians, believe we need law reform here. But neither of the major parties are going to touch it. And that's because they very often pander to a very small minority. And also, you know, these days we seem to want that more diversity in voice. And I think, you know, the internet's had a lot to answer for that. And we're one of the few countries that still has that two-party preferred system.
Fiona, it's Christina Keneally here. Looking at the upper house, the government's going to need 7 votes from the crossbench to get anything through the upper house. But if you look at the breakdown of the minor parties with the numbers as they break down, the Greens, the Shooters and Fishers, the DLP, the Sex Party, it's hard to see how you can put together a coalition of 7 votes from such a disparate group. What's your approach going to be in working with the other people on the crossbench?
Look, I mean, Christina, you would have experienced this in its forms in New South Wales. It is a very diverse group. I certainly think that I'm certainly hopeful that we can work together and look at the issues that we agree on and the issues that we'll agree to disagree on. But I think this hopefully this Parliament will enable us to have greater transparency in the decisions made by government and greater debate in those decisions. For you know, most of the history of Victorian Parliament, the upper house has always been held by the government. So it's been really a rubber stamping, where now we actually will be debating some of the issues and some of the policies that the government's putting forward.
All right, Fiona Patten from the Australian Sex Party, thank you very much for joining us on Studio 10.
Thank you very much.